G'day guys, ZiggyD here, and in this video I want to share some of my first impressions of Legacy League so far. It's already factually correct to say that this is Path of Exile's most successful League launch ever, peaking at over 112,000 concurrent players, which is 10% higher than the previous record according to Chris, and with 40% higher peak-to-peak player counts at primetime over these first few days. This League is doing pretty well so far. After playing it for a few days, I think this could have the potential to be the best challenge league of all time. And why not if you think about it? It's essentially a combo of all of our favourite leagues so far, with the ability to combo and deterministically farm league mechanics and league exclusive uniques. Now, leveling in Legacy felt just right, like League Stones should be a part of the core game. A solid way to incorporate the ever-increasing number of League mechanics into the game in a more impactful but less cluttered way. Like, as we add more and more of these League mechanics, ZiggyD is going to have to start rotating some out, otherwise every single zone would be full of just 50 different things. Now, Legacy League really kicks into gear at endgame once you get to farming maps, and you get to stack prophecies, triple League stones, and map mods all to create some really insane combos and juicy loot or XP-soaked maps. Now, if only the new Zana mods were as interesting, unfortunately. I'm feeling absolutely no compulsion to pay 2 chaos to add monster life to my maps? Yeah, none. If League Stones are going to replace Zana as the way to implement old League mechanics into the core game, then I really hope they can come up with a more interesting set of Zana mods. Things that you can actually combo with League Stones and map mods in interesting ways. After all, it's the crazy and sometimes unexpected ways things combo together in Path of Exile that really makes this game special. When a Breach and Double Beyond map with Nemesis Rares becomes an insane fight for your life, for example. Now, Zana aside, Legacy League has real potential here to go down in history as people's favourite challenge league to date, and more than a memorable send-off to Path of Exile 2.x before 3.0 and 10x changes the game forever. Now, this all said, I think there's a real danger here of a sharp and painful player retention drop-off occurring within a few weeks. And that's the type of thing that could really ruin people's fond memories and stop this league from reaching its full potential. Now, why do I think this? Well, it's mainly a bunch of smaller and almost insignificant seeming, but painful points of balancing on the League Stone mechanics. Firstly, right now, white League Stones are mostly not very engaging. And on top of this, Magic League Stones seem rarer than rares would be if they existed. So you end up running League Stones that just give one lockbox in a zone, or one warband pack, or worse yet, give the monsters Onslaught with literally no other positive effect. The Onslaught League Stone for real, it just makes monsters faster and harder, and does nothing else on its own. Now sure, you get access to a couple of those unique drops that were from Onslaught League, but that hardly makes for engaging gameplay. Now the Magic Onslaught League Stones, on the other hand, can be crazy fun. I had one, for example, that gave players Onslaught and gave something like 40% move and attack and cast speed on top of that. Now that was some insane fun, especially comboing it with Rampage and extra magic monsters or shrines or something like that. But the White Onslaught League Stones? Well, at the moment I'm pretty much just vendoring those in the rather uninteresting 3-for-1 vendor recipe. Next up, what about those Kadiro encounters? Currently the only way to meet the Jolly Golden Santa is if you get a Magic Piranda Stone that actually guarantees it. So I've played almost 50 hours in this league so far, and I've not found a single one of these Kadiro Stones. Let's not forget that when I do find one, he's more than likely to sell me a rare Coral Amulet than anything else. Things like not having a percentage chance for white Pirandus League Stones to spawn Kadiro, much like how the Talisman one has for the Talisman Stones, this sort of thing is going to kill engagement for players fast. I know a lot of people were really excited for the potential of farming and spending Pirandus coins in this league, and if they're not encountering Pirandus, then that's not going to happen. Magic League Stones are super powerful, and the right thing to do might not be to make them more common, but that's what players are asking for right now. And I think that's because of examples like these, of white League Stones being really uninteresting. That said, it could also be a really nice improvement to have a vendor recipe that allows you to trade white League Stones up to magic ones, something somewhat costly like 3 of the same League Stones in a stack of transmutes or something, but it would allow players willing to invest to be able to play a more fun League Stones more often. We could probably also use some quality of life improvements in this league as well. There's a lot of micromanagement in the game already, especially once you're managing talismans and essences and the League Stones and maps and all these things filling your inventory. Some quality of life improvements could go a long way. Like, for example, I saw this suggestion on Reddit to disable League Stones from activating outside of maps. I've wasted about like 15 League Stone charges on visiting Siosa alone. I'm sure many of you guys can echo that particular annoyance. being able to stack League Stones in kind of like a Plinko dropping fashion that they drop down into the boxes when ones are consumed would be pretty damn nice as well. Now I have passed these points of feedback onto Chris Wilson, and he said he's sending it to a few key members of the GGG team, so hopefully we quickly see some improvements. Because again, I think that this could well be the best challenge league of all time. I've already been having a blast playing this league, and playing way too much, getting very little sleep, trying to get a headhunter or a relic drop. But I'm worried that mine and the interest of the player base will quickly wane if some of these small seeming but important things aren't addressed. I also encourage you guys in the comments or on Reddit to share some of your concerns or things that you think could be improved. I can say for certain GGG is keen to hear them and will be keeping an eye out. Anyway guys, that's my first impressions and thoughts. If you're new to the channel, please subscribe to catch future PoE content. That's it for now, I'm ZiggyD, and thanks for watching. I'm adding like epic drops today, what's doing with that? Where's my epic drops, man?
In a long lost dream, great foes hide in tiny boxes.
Monstrous treasure, that certainly helps. Let's have some fun, shall we? Let's roll some lockboxes. What? What are these guys doing here? It literally says area contains no monsters. What's going on here? The hell? How's this happening? What are you guys doing here? You guys shouldn't be here. That was weird. Pack of magic monsters. Four additional items. Let's try my luck on it. Give me a six link. It's not very many additional items, but we'll go for it. Whoa. Not ideal. Oh. Five link. Ooh. Those stats. That's a decent five link, man. Look at that thing. Also, now it's happening. It's finally happening. It's finally happening, guys. It's finally happening. All right. Singularity and a diviner right there. Serrated arrow quiver. That's not a headhunter. But I have Nemesis active. Alright, diviner time. Okay, fine. Let's do this. This could be good. This can work. We at least need a double mod. Oh baby. Oh baby.
Too much clutter.
I can't even pick them all up! Currency, incantations, Montreal's grasp. Not really very expensive, but I do want one of those. Tibula Rasa, Kelsob, Souls, Axe, Stuff, Disfavor. Whoa, buddy, that's a good one. We did get a last one standing. That is a tidy 44 chaos, 45 chaos there. Oh, buddy, yes, we did it. We got another random pack over here again. I think the League Stones are bugging out the Monstrous Treasure a little bit. Oh, those Molten Shells are gonna obliterate my zombies. Oh god. Yep. That goes down four. We lost some Zombros. Alright, plenty more where that came from. Oh! Second Diviners! No way! No way! Second Diviners! Shit. I don't like that essence drainer. Anything good? I mean, I reckon we probably won't get anything good from this one. We got a big win with the last one. Surely not, like, surely nothing of value in this one, right? Well, I got three fusings from it at least. 1/12 of an exalted orb. It's a couple cows. Not bad. Blood of corruption. I don't think that's worth anything. Five cows, apparently. Oh, we've done all right. Some bits and pieces of currency. 1/6 of a six-link body armor. Fuck, man. We did all right. Six-ish chaos, maybe. Man, we did pretty well. Those are the money ones. There's a decent amount of money right there. 15-something chaos, I don't know. That's pretty good. little too good, really. Considering we got the disfavor card in the last one. Diviners are too juicy.